Hello and welcome. My name is Papa Sean. This is Lead Dangerous, and I wanted to explain what the resource extraction points are. So we're currently out in a resource extraction site. If I look over at the navigation, you can see that we are in a low. All right, so we're 6 kilometers out from the low, and if we go to target it, you can see that it's going to be an asteroid field. There are going to be various different types of asteroids based on have rocks. And so you want to be roughly in that 6 kilometer range on these resource extraction points if you have some time. And you don't have to have any inventory on you. You know, if you do, the pirates will come after you and attack you. They'll threaten you first, and you can have an opportunity to toss them some goods. Otherwise, you can go flying around scanning them down, and if they're pirates, you can open up on them. And it's helpful to get a bunch of quests and things in the area for it. But resource extraction sites come in different difficulty levels. The lowest being low resource extraction site, followed by just plain resource extraction sites, kind of like your medium. And then you'll get into the high and hazardous. Hazardous is different from low, medium, and high in that there won't be any police that come to help in hazardous. And you're going to get the strongest, most powerful, skilled pirates in the game. In the high range, you're probably going to get masters, deadlies, you might get some on occasion an elite, but all of those elites and higher are going to be, like in that area, are going to be in the hazardous resource extraction points. So obviously, if you want to get started with pirate hunting, or if you want to complete your quest quickly, you might go to a low resource extraction point, because generally, the pirates, they are all made equal. It doesn't matter their skill level. You get more experience in your own character by going after the higher level ones. But if your level is pretty low, then you get a lot of experience off those low level pirates anyway. And you can complete those quests out to get the rewards rather quickly, blowing up some easy pirates. All right. So another thing that to note is that high resource extraction zones also have these asteroids that are mineable. So if you want to get started with mining and you want to have a little fun while you're doing it with pirates, maybe you have a mining ship that has automated turrets on it. Type 10 has a lot of hard points that you can put turrets on to fire, and you can pick up two mining lasers, and you can just mine while your turrets blast away at pirates that are trying to steal from you. But keep in mind that they will also launch the limpets that will hatch break you, and then you'll dump your cargo. So you want to make sure you'll probably have some of those, flat cannons on your deployments, where you can shoot down any incoming limpets that want to do the hatch break. But yeah, that's the resource extraction site. You want to stay pretty close to that center of it if you're looking for action. The further you get away from it, you might find that you're not getting any more spawns. And if you happen to not like the RNG on your spawns that you're getting, maybe you want more pirates, maybe you want less pirates, you can always just exit to the main menu and come back in, and that will reset. You could also jump out, go into Super Cruise, and then come back into the resource site, and that will also reset your zone, and you'll get different flavors. So maybe you get bigger ships, smaller ships, more ships, that kind of thing.
Scan detected.
Another thing to note in the high resource, as you get higher up, you'll also have wings. So instead of it just being one ship attacking you by itself, it might be three. It's not a bad place to go. If you don't have to farm, you probably want to go into a new resource zone to have the lowest level of the everything except for hazardous, or if you're in anarchy. Okay. Hopefully that helps you guys in understanding the resource extraction sites. And if you have any questions, please put them in the comments, and I will be happy to respond. Until next time, like and subscribe, and happy questing.